Okay, Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So, I'm going to present a video for chapter 1 for our course, Introduction to Electronics and Basic Amplifiers. So, basically, for EECE 1312, we are going to cover 4 devices. So, the first one is the PN junction diode, which allows current to flow in only one direction. So, you can see here, this Superman there is flying in only one direction, right? So, of course, we are going to cover the analysis of PN junction diode and how it is constructed and so on in future chapters. Okay, the second device is the bipolar junction transistor or BJT. So it has 3 terminals, emitter, base and collector. BJT works by applying a voltage at the base terminal, okay, and the voltage must be large enough to turn on the transistor so that the current can flow. But of course, you will learn about this in chapter 4 and 5 later on. The next device is the field effect transistor. It is also a 3 terminal device, source, gate and drain. And also, you have to apply a large enough voltage to terminal gate so that you can allow current to flow. And you're going to learn about this in chapter 6 and 7, right? Another device is the op-amp, which is covered by chapter 8. Okay, so yeah, those are the 4 devices that we are going to cover in our course. Alright, okay, so in basic circuit, you covered the passive components. So this is defined as components that do not require or depend on power supply for their operations, or in other words, the device which electrical characteristics does not depend on the power supply. So you learn about resistor, inductor and capacitor. Okay, however, in this course, you are going to cover another types of components known as active components. So, these components depend on power supply for its operation or the device which electrical characteristics depend on the power supply. So, we covered, for example, transistors and diode. So, these 2 components are the important aspects in electronic circuits. You can see in this statement here. Okay. So, this is the block diagram of an electronic circuit. So you can see in this block diagram, actually for this course, the main important aspect is the amplifier. So this amplifier block will require a power supply in order to make the device to work in the desired region. Okay, so this is known as biasing. Don't worry about that, we're going to cover later. So what is an amplifier? Okay, so basically the keyword is amplify. You are making it bigger, right? If you have a low signal power as the input to this amplifier, you will get an output that has a high signal power. So this output is going to be fed to a load. So when you talk about amplifier, making it bigger, it means that you are dealing with a parameter known as gain. Okay? And that's how this electronic circuit works. So next, we are going to talk about the 2 types of signals, analog and digital signals. So of course, analog signal is a signal that varies with time. Okay? It bears the information by altering the characteristic of the voltage or current. Okay, and most importantly, in an analog signal, the characteristic of the voltage or current which represents the information can be of any value because it is a time varying signal. However, the other types of signal is the digital signal, and it has a discrete value. So this is referred to as quantization. Okay, and the information only has 2 values, high or low, okay, or 0 or 1, and this is also referred to as binary signal. Okay, so next let's talk about representation of signal. So let's say you have this AC supply and a DC supply that are connected together, okay, and the AC is represented as VBE with small letters, and the DC supply is again VBEQ, but all are capital letters. The output when these 2 sources are combined is denoted as also VBE. You can see that the format is different. The BE for the subscript is capital and the main parameter is small letter. Okay, so these notations are important for you when you are going to sketch representation of signal. So this question are sometimes given to you as quiz, where I give you an AC signal and a DC signal and you need to sketch what is the output. Okay, so let's go back to this diagram. So let's say VBE is a sine wave denoted by Vm sine omega t, alright?
And let's just consider the phase as 0, alright? So let's say that it is 5 sine omega t, okay? So let's say that this is your AC signal, okay? And your DC signal is given as, for example, 3 volt, okay? So now this 3 volt and this 5 sine theta is combined together. So how would you sketch the output, okay? So firstly, if it is plus 3, it means that it will be shifted upward as follows, okay? So the axis of your sine wave will be shifted upward by a value of 3. So let's say this power supply is inverted, which means that the negative sign is at the top, then it will be shifted downward by that DC value, okay? Let's say you want to sketch the output and label the values, okay? So in order to do that, you need to start by sketching your sine wave. So your sine wave is 5 sine theta, right? Which means that the peak value is 5 volt, okay? And the peak value in the negative cycle is minus 5, okay? And just to recall, the DC voltage is 3 volt, alright? So this is a positive DC supply, which means that your sine wave will be shifted upward by a value of 3, okay? So it will be shifted upward by a value of 3 volt, okay? And then you can see that the peak value will change, because now originally the peak value is 5, but now the axis has shifted upward by a value of 3, which means that the peak value will be 5 plus 3. So the peak value will be 8, and this portion will be minus 5 plus 3, and it will be minus 2. Okay? It is very important for you to know what are the peak values first, so that you can draw correctly. Okay? Because in this case, we know that the value at which the axis has been shifted is less than the peak value. So the peak value during negative cycle will still be in the negative portion. Okay? Let's say it is plus 6. Then you will see that this negative portion will be going up into the positive part of your output axis. Okay? So that's it. That's how you can sketch a representation of signal when you are given two types of voltage supply. So as I mentioned just now, the most important block in the electronic circuit is the amplifier, right? So let's look at the first amplifier block, which is the voltage amplifier. And you can see here, this is the voltage amplifier block, and any amplifier will always have the input side and the output side, and must also have its input resistance denoted as Ri and output resistance denoted as R0, okay? So if you are dealing with voltage amplifier, you will have this voltage source, and it is given as AVVI. So you can see how the output side is related to the input side is with this term VI, okay? So AV is referred to as the open circuit voltage gain, okay? So why is it called open circuit voltage gain? If there is no load, so basically this is an open circuit, right? Current will not be able to flow to complete the circuit because of this open circuit, right? So there is no voltage drop across your R0, okay? So AVVI will be equivalent to Vout, okay? So if AVVI equivalent to Vout, so AV, which is the gain, is equivalent to Vout over Vin. As I mentioned just now, when we talk about amplifier, the most important parameter is the gain. And gain is always output over input. So it doesn't matter if you are talking about voltage amplifier, then the parameter will be the output voltage over the input voltage. Later you will see that when we talk about current amplifier, then you will look at the output current over the input current. Okay? So just to recap, the voltage amplifier block will have input resistance and output resistance, okay? And this AV is referred to as the open circuit voltage gain, because when there is no load attached to the terminal, this is open circuit, current will not be able to flow, so there is no voltage drop, so AVVI will be equivalent to Vout. And in order to get the gain, it's Vout over Vin. So remember, there is no unit for gain, because you will cancel out the unit. Volt over volt will be cancelled out. Okay, so let's look at one example. So example 1, the output voltage of an amplifier is 10.5 volt when its input is 150 millivolt. Determine the voltage gain of the amplifier. So this is a very straightforward question. Question asks what is the voltage gain of the amplifier, and you are given the standard voltage amplifier block. Okay, so you are given the output and input. So just calculate the gain, output over input, and you will get 70. So this AV is the open circuit voltage gain because there is no load connected to the terminal. What I meant by load is there is no resistor. Yeah, there is no resistor connected at the output terminal. Okay, so let's look at example 2, and you can see this time the structure is a bit different. A load resistance of 475 ohm, which is here, is connected with the output of a voltage amplifier. Okay, the output voltage across the load resistance is 10.5 volt. Okay, given here, when the amplifier input is 150 millivolt. Calculate or determine the open circuit voltage gain, AV, of the amplifier. Assume that the output resistance of the amplifier is 25 ohm. Right. So when you faced with this kind of question, it is important for you to identify what does the sentences refer to. Okay, for example, output resistance of the amplifier, it means that you are talking about R0. So in this question, it is labeled for you. So let's say the question did not give you R0. So you should know that this sentence is referring to R0 of the amplifier. Okay, so now this time you can see that the output terminal is connected with a load. Alright, so AVVI is no longer equivalent to Vout because this time the current is allowed to flow and complete the circuit. So there is a voltage drop across R0, and therefore AVVI will not be equivalent to Vout. Yeah? So I hope you understand what I meant by when there is no load and when there is a load. So the question asks you to calculate what is the open circuit voltage gain, AV. But you are given what is the voltage across the load. So what you can do is, for example, this question is using KVL. In this solution here, find the current I0 by doing Ohm's law. 10.5 volt over 475 ohm, you will get the current I0. And because they are all connected in series, they all have the same current, right? I can use Ohm's law again to calculate what is the voltage across R0, right? And I can do KVL. So this is the KVL equation here. So you can see that we use the same I0 and multiply with R0 to get this voltage, and you will get 11.05 volt. So AVVI equivalent to 11.05 volt. And because VI is given, you can calculate what is the open circuit voltage gain, AV, which is 73.67. Okay, so you have to look at the question. So just take note whether the output terminal is connected with a load or not. So now let's look at the last example. So this time, the open circuit voltage of a voltage amplifier is 12.5 volt when its input is connected to a signal source. Assume that the signal source voltage is 2.5 volt and its resistance is 2 kilo ohm respectively. If the input and output resistance of the amplifier is 5 kilo ohm and 50 ohm respectively, you are to calculate the value of AV, which is the open circuit voltage gain. And what if you have a load, okay, of 500 ohm? You are asked to calculate what is the output voltage across the load resistance. So there are two parts of this question. Now, I would like to highlight to you this term. Open circuit voltage of a voltage amplifier means you are given what is AVVI. Okay, so AVVI is the open circuit voltage. Alright, so that's why I have written here AVVI equivalent to 12.5 volt. Okay, so this voltage amplifier is connected to a signal source and the voltage is 2.5 volt. And the signal source has a resistance, which is RS, and it is 2 kilo ohm. Okay, and then the term here, input and output resistance of the amplifier, which means that you are referring to RI and R0. So now let's look at part 1. Calculate the value of AV. I have written the steps here. Calculate the value of VI, and then we know that the open circuit voltage is AVVI equivalent to 12.5. So the first two steps here is to solve part I. Okay, and then for part 2, because now it is connected with a load, right? So you are asked to find what is the output voltage. So you can use KVL to find what is the current and then use Ohm's law, or you can use voltage divider to find what is the voltage across the load resistance. So I'm going to solve that example following the steps. So you can see I put the answers here at the top right. So calculate the value of VI. So I'm going to use voltage divider at the input side to calculate what is VI. Okay, so you can see at the input side, you can use voltage divider. If you can still remember, the formula for the voltage divider will be VI equivalent to RI over RI plus RS multiplied with the source voltage, which is VS. And then I have the answer VI equivalent to 1.786 volts. But in order to calculate what is AV, you use the AVVI value, which is 12.5, and just put in the value of VI calculated here, and you will get AV equivalent to 7, which is the answer. Okay, now part number 2 is when you have a load resistance at the output terminal. So you are asked to calculate what is the value of Vout if you have this load. Okay, so I can use voltage divider as well at the output side. Okay, so Vout equivalent to RL over RL plus R0 multiply with the voltage, which is AVVI. And we know AVVI equivalent to 12.5. So you can calculate what is Vout, which is 11.36 volt. So basically, in order to solve the amplifier block, you just need to use your basic circuit knowledge, KVL, KCL, and voltage divider, and more importantly, Ohm's law, in order to calculate these parameters. There are a couple more examples in this slide, so why don't you guys try that? And I'll see you in the next video with the next part of chapter 1 about current amplifier. Okay, bye. Assalamualaikum.